I'm at least at back reporting.
Anywhere, but you know, again, the money in the small divisions are in the super flags right now, 115. That's why I wouldn't be surprised if Daigo Higa moves into the 115s because he's a true sensation in my opinion.
I think Inoue will be that, and
well, Inoue has been, he said he's going to 118, but the money is on 115.
So if I was his
advisor, I would say stay a little bit on 115 because
if he can,
there's money there. Yeah. However, there's a lot of interesting talent. Wouldn't you like to see Gallo versus Shuisake?
Yeah, they're talking about that.
Question that's is in Thailand or is in the? It's going to be in the U.S. Right? Yeah. It's going to be part of the.
I think
Bill
wants it.
Yeah.
You got Gallo Estrada. You got Cuadras who beat
Rungasai.
Right, yeah.
Lost to Estrada in a close fight.
You know,
and you have Jerwin Akanjas, how about Masago?
There's some prospects in that division. I mean, Antonio Vargas, the U.S. Olympian, will probably end up there. Nico Hernandez, the Olympic product medalist, might end up there. Butterfly, you know, there's a lot of good prospects going on. And Japan will always produce, you know, world champions in that division. Then you have Mexico, Philippines, etc.
Okay. If Deontay Wilder doesn't fight King Kong Ortiz, if that fight is off, who does Wilder fight next?
Let me say it.
Go ahead.
Well, supposedly Oscar Rivas.
Why supposedly?
Well, I was told something today.
Oh, that's the rumbling.
Yeah.
Okay. When does that fight happen? November?
Yeah.
3 weeks?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
3 weeks. So, that's a case that it should be taking priority to see what's going to happen with Ortiz, because the fight is still scheduled for in about 3 weeks. And so it's interesting. We're waiting for those two results in the convention, right? The Ortiz result and the Neri result. Everybody's looking for that.
Tomorrow we'll know.
Yeah.
I saw Brandon Rios was ranked 14 in the 147 division.
And he's gonna fight Danny Garcia, no?
That's what they're saying. Yeah, he's going to fight Danny Garcia. And then I also heard that Sean Porter wanted to fight Danny Garcia.
Right.
So who's Sean Porter fighting?
Granados.
He's fighting Granados.
Yeah.
What do you think about that one?
I think it's a good fight, but Porter's just too big and strong for him.
You just said it's a good fight, but now he's a Broder. Which one is it?
Yeah, it could still be a good fight. I mean,
it's a good fight, but one guy's a 10, one guy's a...
Obviously, I'd rather see...
Well, obviously, Granados is a D-side. I mean, there's no rocket science to it. But I think he can make a nice fight, in my opinion.
Granado should be a 140. He's got a better chance of winning the big fights down there than he does at 147.
Different waters for Granado.
Okay, Manny Pacquiao comes back next year, or is that it?
I will think he's taking his time. I think that rematch shot with Horn is going to happen. I think there's a lot of money in there, and I think he's motivated by that. You know?
Okay, Miguel Cotto. I heard he may be fighting Lemieux. I thought it's a very dangerous fight for him for his health.
I really congratulate Miguel Cotto for choosing such a beast on his retirement fight. I mean, I really clap this.
I'm worried about his health.
That's a fight that I would love to see. What a match. I hope it happens. And felicidades al gran campeón boricua Miguel Cotto, por supuesto.
Now he needs it for the island with the tragedy they happened. They need something to uplift their spirits.
I haven't thought about that. Yeah, sure.
But Lemieux is a
very momentum marketing wise to carry the island,
yeah,
the whole crowd into a big battle with David Lemieux.
But Lemieux is a very dangerous
fighter.
Yes,
yeah.
I mean, he could lose the whole fight and then knock you out in one punch. So
yes. That's why it makes it interesting, you know? And that's why it was very surprising to me that on his last fight, he has chosen such a fighter, you know? Yeah. Definitely a pay-per-view fight. That's a pay-per-view, and that's a fight that I paid for.
That's a warrior in Miguel Cotto.
Yes.
But he was a beast in the lower weights.
Yeah.
And now, okay, last thing. Mikey Garcia, who do you want to see him fight next? He's ranked champion at 135 WBC, but he's fought at 140. He can move up to 47. He can fight 30, 35.
I think before he moves into a permanent 140, I think he should face Jorge Linares. I think that they both had that in their minds. I think that it's been talked. And I think I have good confidence that it's a fight that is going to happen. And it's going to be a very interesting fight, you know?
Who do you guys like in that one?
Mikey.
I don't take any sides.
The fans are the winners.
Fans are the winners. Great match.
Mikey.
Why?
It's too strong. I mean, Linares, even though he's done good, that you can't ignore the past.
Right.
Mikey is just so precise in that 135.
Mikey?
Yeah, but the speed is Linares.
Yeah, but once he...
How is he going to counter that speed?
Well, Mikey's very accurate.
Mikey.
Okay.
The timing, the power. The fundamentals, the accuracy, and just like lethal power. It's just...
Has Mikey fought any boxer with characteristics similar to Jorge Linares on speed, particularly?
As far as speed, probably not.
Broner? No.
No.
Broner has very fast hands, but he can't let his hands go.
Yeah, but he's much... Linares is much,
yeah, no,
much
no,
smaller.
Dominant.
I think Linares is much quicker than... On the quick movements, he's much quicker than Broner, in my opinion.
He was...
You know?
It's like, what was it? Like, Mikey was dropped by Rocky Martinez and sort of... Didn't get dropped, but you know,
flash knocked down and he got up and shook it off and knocked him out.
I guess Burgos also in the beginning, he didn't get hurt or anything, but he was just
now on that fight. On that fight, I mean, it's no question the power is with Mikey. Mm-hmm. What the power is Mikey, but where the boxing skills are, Mikey has good boxing skills, but Jorge Linares is a great professional when it comes to that, a great artist.
The technical.
Yeah.
All right, I hope the fight happens. It's a big
great
one.
Great match, yeah.
All right, there you have it. Stay tuned. FuseReporting.com. I'm Melissa, back reporting.
Your A game, and like you said, human error does exist.
Listen, it's very easy to score a basketball game. It's very easy to score a baseball game, but boxing is so subjective, and
right. Everybody
has their own little...
Stylist,
they shouldn't have. Yeah, but they should just be a good judge, but people are human, and, you know, there could be so many elements and factors.
There's stylistic preferences, but there are so many different dimensions within that. You know, one style, you know, whether it's pure pressure fighters, and you know, there's all these nuances and subtleties that makes every single fighter different. Or also from the pure boxing standpoint, do they stay in the pocket or does movement equate to setting the pace?
Don't leave it in the judges' hands, if possible.
Yeah.
That would solve a lot of problems, but when it does go on, it's a great fight, like the Canelo Triple G fight.
Right.
Tomorrow they have the mandatories. Are you excited about that, to see who they're going to set up, what fights are coming up for next year?
Well, it's always nice to see what's up, to see what, you know, what's going on in each of the weight classes. I think it's interesting. I think that, you know, there's very exciting divisions nowadays. Right now, and there are a few that we're definitely looking forward to seeing.
Like which fights would you want to see in boxing right now?
I don't know. Let's talk about, you know, go ahead.
Yeah, I mean, Muhammad Wasim from Pakistan, who's with the Korean promoter at flyweight, is number one in that WBC rankings. Daigo Higa is the world champion. You know, that was...
I wonder who...
There were a lot of things in the... Sorry.
I wonder who's going to fight or who's going to be Daigo's Mando.
Yeah.
That's going to be interesting.
Because there were a lot of things in the ratings meeting today that were pushed to tomorrow because of concern the mandatory position. But I think... We'll see if Wasim gets that mandatory spot or if they order a fight with him later between him and Chiwas.
The Chiwas are on there.
Yeah. Chiwas is number two.
Yeah.
Francisco Rodriguez.
Who?
Francisco Chiwas Rodriguez.
Yeah. Oh, no, but I'm saying...
But he has fought at 115, not 112,
yeah.
Really.
He's a big guy. He shrunk down, you know, to 105.
Getting into the heat of the moment.
It's also the later Alvarez and R. Stevenson that might finally happen. That's been delayed like 2 years. So.
Who wins that one? It happens in Canada probably because...
Yeah.
Adonis sells out.
Quebec,
yeah. I mean, if... I love the fight. You know, I've been waiting for that fight for a long time. Stevenson versus Eleider Alvarez on the 175s for the championship. This is the second time that Eleider Alvarez is called to do that mandatory. The first one, he was given a step aside, and I guess the second one too. Meanwhile, we have very little activity from the champion Adonis Stevenson. That's just pure fact. So I'm really looking forward to that fight because Elder always has always been an underdog, you know, an underrated sorta.
And he keeps winning.
And he, you know, he has good wins, and he's gonna be and he's undefeated, you know. So it's an interesting fight that definitely Adonis Stevenson has a great talent, and but that night he's gonna have to go out and do some work.
Who did he beat last? Was it Fonfara Alvarez?
Fonfara on a devastating knockout, right?
Right, it was a second round knockout, and you know, Fonfara was just a goner, you know. The fight prior, you know, he was struggling against Chad Dawson, and...
I tweeted in the last round, he needs a knockout to win, and he got the stoppage.
And the question is, Fonfara really at 175, or is because he goes to the weight... to weight is too weak because he may, in my opinion, he may be a cruiserweight.
He's a big dude.
He's a big guy, you know, tall guy. Well, definitely an interesting fighter too.
Andre Ward retired. Are you happy? Are you sad?
Is that a strategy to gain more equity a little bit further down the line?
It is possible because I heard rumors that he might be going to Top Rank, but
I have to say that I loved when he briefly mentioned that he wouldn't discard going into the cruiserweights. When I heard that, I liked that. But, you know, it's his career, it's his legacy, and...
Why not leave on top? If Roy Jones Jr. left on top, he would have been considered right now one of the best ever if he didn't stay a little too long in boxing. So you can respect that, at least leaving the point where people could argue.
Well, look at Klitschko. Klitschko could have made a lot of money on this second rematch. He chose not to.
Yeah.
You know, that was a big number, Eli.
It was.
On the second one.
Yeah.
And, huge but number.
A month before or so, right? 6 weeks
yeah,
before.
Yeah, I mean, that's really like...
But he's smart. Why take... If you're not there, you're not there. Yeah.
He had nothing to prove. I mean, he really had nothing to prove. Apparently, like, him versus Callum Johnson was agreed to. But HBO wouldn't take the fight. So if those are the type of fights he was going to be trying to do, then what's the point?
Let me tell you what Buddy McGirt told me once. A great line. An athlete is the first to know, but the last to admit when it's time to retire. Nobody wants to retire, but they're the first ones to know when it's... But Klitschko knew it. This year, a lot of people retired. Marquez, Ward, Klitschko.
Yamanaka.
Maybe Chocolatito. We don't know yet. I could go on.
Well, that's an interesting point.
Holy Malinaji.
Chocolatito is an interesting. You know, they're thinking about doing Jafai with Chocolatito. But anybody that cares for Chocolatito, I think he needs to rest a little bit. He needs to
rebuild.
Have a good rebuild and go back nice and easy, you know?
So, there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Eli Sekpak reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter at Sekpak. And you can follow me on Instagram at Eli Sekpak.